Madam, I rise to speak on the rights of persons with disabilities bill 2016. I am so happy to see the condition of the house today. If only the ruling party had this intention in mind, then the debate on demonetization could have been held.
Ye kya hota hai?
But unfortunately, no. I speak on this bill only.
Okay, thank
you. I am so happy at this situation. Madam, you sitting quietly without getting excited, and the ministers all sitting in their seats. This is an ideal situation. Why we could not do it, I lament.
It should
because
be
the session
there.
Is a washout in any case. But I rise to speak on the rights to disabilities bill.
Yes.
First thing I want to mention is that this bill was brought to Rajya Sabha in 2014. At that time, Mr. Arun Jaitley, who was leader of the opposition in Rajya Sabha, said that this bill should not be passed urgently. We should send it to the standing committee. The standing committee submitted its report in 2015, and now the bill has come in end 2016. Of course, it's better late than never. There has been 2 years in actually passing of the bill. There is no doubt that bill has very many improved features for which we must commend the government that for the first time a comprehensive legislation has been brought forward for the aid of those who are disadvantaged, some from birth, some through accidents or diseases acquired later. They are the really the most unfortunate, condemned people in our society. It's good that the parliament is one in passing this bill, that we are at least, whatever our political differences, we are with this very disadvantaged people. We have shown that much of humanity and compassion, which is a good thing in itself. Now there are certain, Mr. Venugopal has spoken at length, and there are certain good features in the bill which the minister has also mentioned. Main thing is that they have included 21 disabilities as part of disabilities. For instance, for the first time, autism and intellectual problem or learning disorders has been included. For the first time, learning disorders like dyslexia has been included. I did not know for a long time that there was a disease such as dyslexia. Only after seeing Aamir Khan's Tare Zameen Par, I came to know that there is such a learning disorder. So now that has also been included. And for the first time, acid attack victims, who are a big problem to society, they have been included. And Madam, that day during release of Bhartrihari Mohtar's book, we are talking of the problems of the old people, senior citizens, those elderly who are hit by geriatric diseases such as Parkinson's disease. Now Parkinson's disease has also been included as a disability, which I strongly commend. Also, for the first time, blood disorders like thalassemia, hemophilia, they have been included. They are not there earlier, but we know what problems people with thalassemia and hemophilia are faced. Now, I support Mr. Venugopal when he said that reservation should be increased to 5% instead of 4% as promised in the bill. I hope that in this atmosphere of cordiality, the minister will accede to our request. There is no loss of prestige if you accept the opposition recommendation on this very important matter of reservation for the persons with disabilities. Also, there is 5% reservation in land allotment by the government. So if there is 5% reservation there, there should be 5% reservation in employment. Now the central and state advisory boards are being formed, and our parliament will also elect members to the central board. MLAs will also elect people to the state advisory boards. As Mr. Venugopal has suggested, I again support him, that the district advisory boards should also have representatives of the people. If you don't want MLAs and MPs, at least the district Zilla Parishad members or some representative people should be kept in the district advisory board. Now, for the first time, a national fund for persons with disabilities is being created, and it will mainly depend on central allotments. I do hope that finance ministers in future allot sufficient money for allotting funds to the help of the disabilities. There is also a committee for research on disabilities, which is very good, because a lot of these disabilities could be cured if there is proper training. Now, 2 points in brief I want to mention. Our country is not disabled friendly. Madam, you travel to the West very often. Every building there has got a ramp. Every transport there has got a ramp for people with orthopedic problems. We have not been able to introduce that in our trains, in our buses, and in our, even in some government buildings, these ramps had not been put for handicapped people. That is, should be strictly implemented, this help for the disabled. Lastly, madam, I have been working with disabled for many years, and now the National Institute of Orthopedically Handicapped is in my constituency in Bonhugli. And also, branches of the National Institute of Visually Handicapped and the Hearing Handicapped, they are also in the same campus. But I find that the NIOH is very badly maintained, very badly managed, and there is a big rush of patients there. Not sufficient doctors, particularly doctors who can perform surgery on the orthopedically disabled. I want the minister to give personal attention. I sometimes talk to him on this mission, on the improving the services at the National Institute of Orthopedically Handicapped. Last one point is that, madam, many people do not know that the central government has a scheme to give free appliances to the handicapped, wheelchairs, tricycles, blind sticks, then hearing aids. All this is distributed free. But we have to organize camps. Now, to organize a camp for 2,000 people, it takes a lot of money. There is no help from the government. And then again, in camps, there is a problem that unless they have the disability certificate, they will not get this aid from the government of India. So I would request the minister to make this problem of having certificates not compulsory, not mandatory, but optional, so that more people, when the government of India is giving the funds, and on my request minister has sanctioned two camps in my constituency and three camps in backward areas of West Bengal, all on my request. I have again written to him for 7 more camps to organize this. I would like the rules for camps to be made simple. That's why, ma'am, we support this bill wholeheartedly. With the 59 amendments, now there is not much left to amend in the bill excepting the reservation. In this context, I would quote from Tagore, Hemor durbhaga desh jahader korecho apoman, apomane hote hobe tahader sobar soman. Manusher odhikare bonchito korecho jare, sommukhe taniya ene, tobu kole dao nai sthan, apomane hote hobe tahader sobar soman. Oh, my unfortunate country, those who have been insulted by you, ultimately, the country will be insulted by them. So unless we can do proper justice to the disabled, we shall not be fulfilling our duties as citizens of the country. Lastly, A bill from the minister is still pending. That
how
is
much
madam.
Last
this,
point?
This is with regard to transgenders. That bill we had in the discussed as a private member's resolution. The minister promised that he would bring the bill on transgenders.
Yes, yes.
I would request him to also expedite bringing the bill, and we will pass it unanimously again.
Thank
just
you.
As we are passing this disabilities bill in a parliament session racked by controversies and disturbed by commotion.
Thank you.
Thank you.